Sergiu Bursuc, a basket full of secret key, or secret shares.
Yeah, yeah. Or secret keys. So yeah, we had some private data, and then we were wondering like, okay, what to do to protect it? Do we make up a security solution for it, or do we get some other party to protect it because it's difficult to do security? So we got like two consultants, two cryptographers to consult us. Let's call them Alice and Bob. So Alice told us, well, why don't you use like this secret sharing, which is like, it's great because you don't have to, well, no, first Alice told us, don't do it by yourself because security is hard. Just let some other people do it, like outsource it to someone. But it says, okay, it's better not to trust like a single party, just maybe just secret share your secret and use a few parties and that will be better. We thought, okay, yeah, that sounds nice. And but the problem is, okay, we still have like, okay, now instead of one secret, you have like n secrets, so we still have a problem because okay, what do we do with this with these shares? Okay, we have to find someone who we say, okay, would you be able to hold my share, or would you? So it's still a problem. So instead of one problem with how to protect the secret, we have like n problems how to protect each share. So that was a problem for us. So we went to Bob and said, okay, Bob, what do we do? Because Alice has this great idea, but okay, we are not convinced about it. So Bob said, well, wait a minute, your secret is it's valuable, right? So, well, if your secret is valuable, then, well, why don't you just, instead of buying space or buying some service to protect your share, why don't you just sell your shares, you know? Because that's, I mean, it is actually a convincing business case study, you know, okay, because, you know, it's some valuable share of some secret, so. So we thought, yeah, that's interesting. So we packaged all this story together. We went to investors and said, well, yeah, so we have these shares and okay, we'd like to sell them and so on. And then it turns out that, okay, the investors there, they have some very interesting requirements. like they would be interested to know, for example, well, they don't just want to give money and then just stay in some share there, which doesn't. And in particular, they're interested, you know, in growth potential. So they want to, okay, you know, I'm going to give money, then the share is going to be, you know, will it grow? Well, in this particular case, literally, will your share grow? So we were thought, okay, we don't know about that. Will it grow? So we went back to Alice and said, would it be possible to make this share like grow, like in some sense? And I said, so I don't think it can grow. It's not supposed to grow, but I don't know what I can do for you. And I said, okay, tell us. Well, I can give you a proof that it cannot grow. What can I do with the proof that a share cannot grow? Can the proof grow? Alice says, okay, the proof cannot grow, but I can give you as many proofs as you want, so that's actually interesting, right? And we said, okay, if you give me as many proofs as I want, then I can do something with that, right? So we went. So this is a very nice story because we can get for a share as many different proofs as you want, and they are all different. You can repackage them, you can resell them, and so on. So it's very cool. So so it turned out this is very interesting, and so the investors were happy, and said, yeah, okay, this is very interesting. I think I'm interested in your shares. Actually, I want them all. Yeah. So we said, oh, he wants all our shares. That's fine. Well, that's fine. That's brilliant. So we were happy. We sell them all the shares. The investors was happy. Alice was not happy. I mean, Alice. We went back to Alice. She said, okay, it's crazy because, well, if you've been to the talk last week, this is like means the entropy of the secret is zero. Just to use the vocabulary. So so the problem was that Alice was not happy, but she was even less happy when she found out that actually the contract we couldn't even tear down the contract because the contract was already on the blockchain. So so we couldn't tear down the contract. We had to tear down the blockchain. So so the question is, do we tear down the blockchain? Actually, well, we will be happy just to remove our data from the blockchain because the contract is on the blockchain, the share is on the blockchain, so everything. And so I'm almost out of time. I don't have to tell you how we did that, but we did some research, and I can tell you we did find some solution, but maybe it will be for next time. Okay.